Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone. Happy to be here. But first, I want to know who you are. Who in the participants is representing the government? Please raise your hand. Not that many. Local communities? Not that many. Okay. Who of you is representing the private sector? Ooh, much more. Ooh, very good. Who of you is representing an NGO, being a research institution or a civil society organization? All right, thank you very much. Now, I know, but also you know, who is in the room. So, I am the coordinator of the Scaling Up Nutrition movement. And the Scaling Up Nutrition movement was started in 2010. I was not at the table. I wasn't at the menu as well, but I wasn't at the table at that time. Under the recognition that nutrition is of crucial importance. And you all know, because you're all experts, you're all involved. But the recognition was there that you cannot improve nutrition if there is no political will. So to improve nutrition, you need political will and country ownership. That was number one. The second recognition was, but to reach this, you do not only need the different departments and the different ministers to work together, but you also need the players in society, civil society, research and know-how institutions, but also the private sector and the communities to implement it and to get nutrition right from the very beginning. Because we all know that the first 1,000 days of a child are the most important for the full development of the body and the brain. So you need government, political will, you need the different stakeholders, and you need investment from the domestic budget. Now, you are right if you think that I'm talking about undernutrition. And indeed, the Sun Movement started to invite countries to take the decision, the political decision, and to come together, to bring different departments together, to show commitment, coherence, accountability, leadership, data, capacity, and finance to invest in improved nutrition, because that's the way forward. And so we started. We don't invite countries to become a member, but we right now have 59 countries and plus 3 states of India who are a member of the Scaling Up Nutrition movement. We have 4 global networks that support our activities at country level, because at country level, it has to happen. Country ownership, country leadership, country commitment. That is where it all has to happen. I see some of you thinking, because it reminds you of something. Indeed. This is also the case in the Sustainable Development Goals. The Sustainable Development Goals, the 17 beautiful goals, interconnected, and if we really manage to implement all of them, we will be successful in reaching a sustainable and thriving society in each country. But it has to be under the commitment of the government. It has to be country-led and country-owned. So here are the things I mentioned. Political leadership. So we want to see the convening power in the office of the Prime Minister or in the office of the President. And the Sustainable Development Goals are not only talking... Now I have to go back. The Sustainable Development Goals are not only talking about undernutrition, because you know the numbers. Arriving yesterday, I was told, well, it's interesting here, but we are all experts. So if we are all experts, we all know that as we speak, we have 159 million children that are stunted and don't get the best start in their life. Not physical, not when it comes to brain development. So they will be impacted for their whole life. We have 50 million wasted children still around the world. But the other thing is, and you really must have heard it, that the number of stunted people will double from now until 2030. And not in little numbers, but it will, in 2005, it was 1.3 billion stunted children and people. And if we are not able to turn it around, we will have, in 2030, we will have 3.28 billion obese and overweight people around the world. So this is impacting a lot. And here is the fact of life. In countries where they are still fighting undernutrition, they see the impact of the double burden of malnutrition. Children that are stunted when they are young become obese and are struck by non-communicable diseases when they are in the reproductive age. And in all the so-called Western countries, some call them donor countries, we see that obesity is a problem. So there is no country around the world that has no problem with nutrition. And here's another fact of life. Nutrition has to be right to implement each and every one of the Sustainable Development Goals. Nutrition is the maker and marker of development, or let me put it stronger, if you don't get nutrition right, forget to implement each of the Sustainable Development Goals. Well, you can examine yourself afterwards during the coffee break or whenever, but you don't get education right if you don't get nutrition right because of the brain development. You don't get health right if you don't get nutrition right. You don't get peace and stability, let alone thriving cities. So go along all the 17 Sustainable Development Goals and be aware that the only way to get them right and to get them implemented is nutrition. Now, what do we have to do? Because, to tell you the truth, I was reluctant to come here. Gunhild invited me already last year to be there, and I refused. Because I said, it's not going to happen there. It's very interesting to bring all these people together. And it is interesting, I have to admit. But where does it have to happen? It is at country level. So this time I agree to be here. I couldn't continue to say no because Gunhild is also very much involved in the Scaling Up Nutrition movement. So I said, okay, I will be there, but let me be very clear with people. I know I want them to act. So what do I want you to do? I'm not very good in this way of operating. I want to see commitment, coherence, accountability, data, leadership, capacity, and finance from the governments. And that is where we come in and we're working in different countries. But I want the same from the other stakeholders. I want the private sector to step up in this field. You can do much more and much better. And you know how not only food companies can do better, but all companies can do better by being a champion in good nutrition, by treating your employees well in whatever country you are working. Be a champion in having mother and child care, in providing the right nutritious food. You can do it all over the world and be a champion by sitting together with the Minister of Agriculture and Food to get the food system right, to make agriculture nutrition sensitive, but at the same time climate smart, and at the same time you save water or make water reusable. But I also want the private sector to move their activities, their social activities, from the corporate social responsibility chapter towards the business case. sustainability and people, because the Sustainable Development Goals are a people's agenda. They don't need to be in a separate chapter. While the business case is still ongoing, making maximum profit, it needs to be in the boardroom, and the decisions that the board is taking have to be transparent and in line with the Sustainable Development Goals. I want NGOs and research institutions to step up. Don't continue to ask for more research when you are in a research institution. Please make sure that your findings and your research is implemented and brought to scale. Work shoulder to shoulder with the communities out there for impact. More research on the shelf is not helping us forward. We need to see impact out there, and we need to see partnership, collaboration built on trust. NGOs have a tremendous important role to play as advocates, of course, but they also have to become reliable partners. I see too many NGOs who continue to criticize private sector, to criticize the government, without stepping up themselves. I want NGOs to bring down their silos, to start to work together, and to collaborate in a way that is really building partnership. I think I need some more time, or I need a bit of water, but I don't have one of them. So I will continue. No problem. So what I want to see is that all partners step up and go out, bring their piece of the puzzle to the table, and do it in countries. Not only in developing countries, also in your own country. Because overweight, obesity, non-communicable diseases are also part of the nutrition coin that have to be solved in a way where partnership is built. And you can only build partnership if you start to trust each other. And how do you start to trust each other? By bringing down your own silos, being committed, building coherence, being accountable, showing leadership, not only for a quick win, but for a longer time, collecting inclusive data, being there to build capacity, and being ready to also invest. Because if you put your money where your mouth is, you have more credibility. And if you are able to do this, I'd like to be back next year. But then, Gunhild, you succeeded in convincing me to be here this year. Next year, I will only come if you change the title of this year, or you have a next title, which is Play Your Part, Get Impact. And bring your impact to the table. Thank you very much.